Hey, what's up now?
Brother, what's up?
This is a big party, man.
Yeah, brother, dig it.
Right on.
Okay, hello.
Hi, Miss Williams.
Hi. Hey.
Hello. This is
Hi, Miss Williams.
Hello. Hi.
It's Umbu.
Is that Miss Umbu?
Yes.
All right. There we go.
All right. We are ready. Thank you all for coming to this discussion of Long Way Down by Jason Reynolds. And I am so thrilled to be interviewing the Moore Williams family. You want to introduce yourselves? Just your first name?
I'm Yates.
I'm Jean.
I'm Gary.
Hi. Well, the first thing I want to start with is, what did you think of the book? Just your general impression.
I thought it was interesting. It had a lot of things that families go through who come up in poverty, in areas of poverty where different things are told to them that they should do and things that they have to follow that aren't really healthy things and aren't good for them, but because their uncle did it or their father did it or it's been put, you know, brought down through the family, that they just follow through because they feel like they're obligated to do it.
Yeah, so, they have those three rules.
Yeah, the rules, yeah.
Yates and Gary, what do you think about those rules, those three rules? Are they still true today, the three rules?
Some of them, I wouldn't say all of them.
Like some okay. Of
them. Like the snitching part, and then, yeah. What's up, bro? Yeah, no crime.
No yeah. Crying.
But I don't think the other one is like, you gotta go kill.
You don't think most boys who've lost a father or brother feel that they're supposed to go and retaliate, take someone else's life because their family member life has been taken. You don't think that that's?
No.
No?
Not all the time.
Not all the time, okay.
Okay, what about the no crying? Is that still the rule?
Yeah, no crying.
Is that just boys or boys and girls or is
it? I would say mostly boys.
Uh-huh, uh-huh. And the no snitching is still a rule?
Yeah, no snitching.
Okay, what other kind of rules do y'all have?
Huh?
Like rules among teenagers. Things that you just have to. Go ahead.
Well, I know we were talking just the other day about, you know, if you don't have the same thing that somebody else have, or you're not dressing the same way, you sort of like are an outcast, or they will ease you or joke you. So that's something we were just talking about the other day. Said if you don't have an iPhone,
right.
You're not in the iPhone club, and you're not, you know, considered as being as good as the people who do have the iPhones. So those are some of the things that's still going on with teenagers, which that's why one of the reasons when they did the dress, everybody dressed the same in the school, the dress code, I think that took some of the pressure off for a lot of children who are not able to get the same things that other children are able to have.
Well, let's talk about the character Will. He's the protagonist. What did you think of him?
I thought he was your typical little brother.
Uh-huh.
Looking up to his big brother. You know, sort of like praising him, pretty much thinking that he was, you know, the best. Uh-huh. Wanted to follow him, wanted to go in his footsteps. Uh-huh. What do you think about Will as far as how he about his big brother?
I think he's going through a lot. He's in pain.
What, Will?
Yes.
And he don't know what to do.
You were saying earlier, Mrs. Williams, about how each person had to kill somebody else, which led to the killing of somebody else.
Yes.
So, for example, Will had to kill, he's going to kill Riggs because he thinks Riggs killed Sean, but then Sean killed somebody. Who did Sean kill?
Who did Sean kill?
It was the white boy.
He killed somebody.
It was the white
boy. Oh, yeah. I don't know.
It
was an innocent person, right? It was someone
new. Yeah. And what about Danny? How does she fit into this?
She was just an innocent bystander in the play yard and playing on the playground.
Yeah, right? They got shot.
And Will was with her when they were very young, and he witnessed it, her being killed. And then afterwards, he wanted to cry, and he was told not to cry then. It really traumatized him. What happened to her, because they were very close and they liked each other.
And what happened with his father, Will's father? What did you think of him?
The father.
Mikey Holloman.
Talk up louder. He killed the innocent.
Will's father killed the innocent guy because he thought the boy that was the new boy that was on the block selling this stuff killed Mark, his brother.
Yeah. So he killed this guy G that he thought killed Uncle Mark. And then what happened to him? What happened to Mikey? He got killed by Frick.
Yes.
I think it was Frick. But it's just one person after another. Like you were, go ahead. You were saying in the beginning about how they keep following the script.
Right.
All right. Well, let's move to something else. This question of, on the very last page of the novel where it says, you coming.
Yes.
There are several ways of looking at this. So what does it mean to you when Sean steps out of the elevator and says, you coming?
Well, to me, I felt like it meant that he was going to follow the rule, and go in and kill his brother, and that he would be killed also, so he would be with them. That's what I took from it.
And what I took from it, at first, I thought in being like, are you coming back on the elevator? Because like I thought he knew like that he couldn't do it no more, or they was trying to get him back
to end the
line. That was the rule that was supposed to keep going on and on. So I thought he was going to get back on the elevator. Yeah.
Wow, I thought that was brilliant the way he ended it that way.
I do too. Yeah, it kept you. It makes you think. I mean, what exactly did you know meant? Is like a cliffhanger, and so you can come up with a couple of reasons or things that might have happened.
So what do you think Will's going to do? Gary, what do you think he's going to do? Which choice is he going to make?
I think he's going to try to kill the person that killed his brother.
You too. Really?
Isn't he the one that made the book?
No.
He said this happened to me.
Yeah, it's just the office.
Oh.
Gary, why do you say you think he's going to kill him? What about you, Yates? Do you think he's gonna kill him?
Me, I don't think so.
Why?
Yates said he does not think so. Talk up.
I don't think so because like First of all, I think he got to go back upset because he peed on himself. And then, and then after everything he was telling, I thought he was going to change his mind and then go back up, because if he's going to be hurting his mother if he do that, because he's going to die. And then, yeah.
Yeah. Interesting.
Yeah, it was.
Because he was, go ahead, Ms. Williams.
I just thought he was going to follow suit and do the same thing. But because none of them really was saying not to do it, but they were telling him he wasn't tough enough to do it.
Yeah.
So I'm not sure that was going to make him really, when people tell you, oh, you can't, and you can't do it, it seems to make you want to do it even more, you know, yeah. The fact that they are telling you you're not tough enough. So that's why I thought maybe he would go ahead and do it, even though he was frightened about doing it.
Ms. Williams, why do you think that families, especially families with young sons, should read this book?
Well, I think it's a good book to read for them to, it can show them how other people's thoughts and the pressure of being a certain way can put you in a bad position, that you really need to, have somebody or go to somebody when something is really pressing like that and get other opinions, and just not act out on what somebody else thinks you're supposed to do, to come up from under that pressure of, because you're a boy or you're a man and this is your position and you have to do it, thing, that not to feel that way. So, and it's a good thing to discuss that with them. So I thought it brought that out really clear how pressured he was, mm-hmm. to go and kill someone else because his family member had been killed. And also probably there was a lot of emotions and feelings and love for his brother that was propelling him too. And then on top of that, you got the rules that are saying, yeah, and this is what you do when this happens. But that, that should not be followed that way. I mean, they need to know you still have other options and choices. So that's why I thought it was a, because it gave us to discuss that and for me to tell them how I felt, for me to ask them what they felt about how he felt, the young man felt.
Mm-hmm. So, Jason, Gary, would you recommend that young people like yourself read this book?
Yeah.
And why?
I say yes, because it's something many people lose people to the streets, and it's not really smart to try and take revenge in your own hands to go kill somebody, because you can end up hurting other people the way you've been hurt.
And innocent people, you're right, innocent people.
Gary, do you have any thoughts?
Gates. She said Gary, but she meant you, because Gary.
Yes.
Gates. You have any thoughts about?
No.
Well, I do want to ask you about this whole no snitching thing, because I, especially the boys, suppose somebody did something to your grandmother, wouldn't you want them to tell the police what they saw?
Yes.
But then yes. If you saw something happen to somebody else's grandmother, would you be able to tell the police what you saw?
Do you feel like you would? If not, why not? If not, is there some reason why you would not? Other than the fact that somebody might look at you as...
Because it's probably not my blood or family member that's getting hurt.
But it's still a person. So if you tell, what we're asking, if you tell, what would be the reason that you would or would not tell? Oh, so you're saying because it's not your family. So you
and no, like if it was like a friend and like a friend and then I knew his grandmother and she was nice to me and everything. Like I would tell, but like I wouldn't.
You wouldn't want to. Okay.
How this came up the other, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Would it be because of danger or fear of what people would think of you? What are some reasons that you would or would not tell? That's what I'm trying to hear from. Yeah. Would you be afraid to tell?
Afraid of who?
Right.
Oh,
no.
Well, because of the people who did it, if they know you're a witness and you're telling, that could be dangerous, right? No, that wouldn't be it.
No, not that's just what I was talking about.
Okay.
Right from being younger. I said right from being younger.
Oh, the thing was you do not snitch.
Since
This came up in the other session too. This is so fascinating to me.
I asked this
question of the seventh graders and they said the exact same thing that your boys are saying.
Wow.
That they would like people to come forward, but they understand if they don't.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if somebody in their family was hurt, they would like the person to come forward, but they understand if they don't.
They understand if they don't, okay. And that is, wow, interesting. So it's the streets that teach this. Well, I don't understand it, but I don't understand it. But I would understand it out of, like I was thinking, fear. That you being a witness and whoever did it wants to retaliate on you. But other than that, as far as, I don't understand why you wouldn't tell.
Would you like that to change, boys? Would you like people to change their views on that, that they should want justice to be done, or?
Would you like for it to be changed?
Yes.
How about you?
Yeah.
Well, Mrs. Williams, I am so grateful to you and to your wonderful, wonderful grandsons for doing this. And is there anything you'd like to say about this experience?
Oh, I enjoyed the book, and I was excited when I saw it come in the mail. And so I just said, we're both going to sit down and read it. So it was a good read for me, and it was a good conversation for us to talk about. And I really liked the way everybody, the way he did the book, because they all winded up in this elevator and this, we finished it in 2 days. Well, it's
yeah.
So, and it was good. It was a good conversation for us. I just want to say, like I said again, thank you so much for sending it to us. And it was a good read and we enjoyed it.